Hello YouTube, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name's Tina and I make videos every single week on lifestyle, beauty, and mostly DIY content. And I wanted to start off this video by saying that I hope that you're all well, hope that everyone is safe and healthy. And it is a crazy time right now, but we're gonna get through this together. And I thought I would bring to you today my floral centerpieces for my wedding video. This video was requested after I had posted a previous video about buyer DIY where I talked about DIYing my own centerpieces for my wedding. And today's video is going to cover that. So this video is going to be broken down into two different parts, and basically I'm going to talk about more generally how I got started with floral decor and kind of getting that underway. So the first part I'm going over is going to be everything that I actually did to get my flowers done. So talking about tutorials and resources that I use to actually plan this, because it is a very, very big project to take on, especially since florals is something that you have to do a couple days before the wedding, so you have to mentally prepare and know what you're doing, otherwise it might not turn out that good. And then the second part of this video is going to be about the companies that I use for the actual flowers and kind of walking through exactly what the process was like, especially since there's so many different companies out there that are offering DIY flowers. And I figured whatever company that you do end up using, it's going to be a very similar experience. So just wanted to show you guys kind of what that looked like. Okay, so we're gonna start this video by talking about how I actually learned how to do flowers. I wanna preface this by saying that I never really learned how to do flowers before, and it was only because I had the thought of doing my own flowers that I actually started looking up tutorials. And the best resources that I found were on YouTube. One of the best YouTubers that I found for floral decor and floral tutorials is Ashlyn Carter. She actually used to own her own floral company and did weddings and stuff like that, and now she kind of just teaches it on YouTube. And her style is exactly what I was kind of going for, so those tutorials really, really helped. So definitely watch her videos. She has different videos for holidays and weddings and stuff like that, so I'm sure you'll find something that you like. So the second thing that I did to learn flowers was actually go to a floral workshop. So I went to a local flower company called Flowers for Dreams. They do bouquets and weddings, and they also host really awesome workshops. So for Valentine's Day last year, I went with one of my best friends and also my maid of honor. So it was nice that she was also learning how to do flowers as well, because let me tell you, you're gonna need help. It was really helpful for her to be there as well, because she went into it knowing that she was gonna do flowers for my wedding as well. So that was also a bonus. And that leads me into the next thing, is after learning, make sure that you practice. So I took different opportunities to practice. Besides the Valentine's Day workshop, I also made flowers for Mother's Day, and I also made flowers for my bridal shower, and I'll obviously put some pictures here. Those are two great ways to kind of understand what type of materials you'll need to actually get this accomplished, especially on a large scale. So I learned how to use floral foam, and I learned how to use the chicken wire, and those are some of the different things that you can experiment with, especially when you're in this learning phase. And after learning how to use flowers and greenery and all that good stuff, I obviously had to think about the different tools that I was going to use, especially since it was not only gonna be me, but it was also going to be my bridesmaids. So the best place that I found tools was actually on Michaels, and Michaels online is really great because they sell things in bulk for very cheap, and obviously when they had a sale. So that really, really helped me cut down the price of the tools I was buying. I will link down below everything that I used for my wedding, but I will say that the tools that I got from Michaels, I bought like literally the cheapest one, and they lasted maybe that one time that I used for the wedding. So if you're planning to use these more than one time, I would say go for the more higher tier tools. But if you're okay with using tools that kind of crap out after one use, then go ahead and use the link that I have down below. Since I was using a lot of bowls and trays and things like that, I couldn't really use chicken wire. And chicken wire is a great option because it is more sustainable and is also really, really cheap to buy. So if you can do chicken wire for your bouquets, I would say go for it. But for the specific style that I was doing, I couldn't use chicken wire, so I had to go with floral foam. And I also found that on Michaels for super, super cheap. And yeah, definitely check out the Michaels wedding website because it is a lot better. A lot of sales all the time, and it is just nicer to shop online versus in store sometimes. And last thing for tools is obviously what you're going to hold the flowers on. So whether it's going to be hanging on an arch, or if it's going to be in a bowl or in these stands that I had at the wedding, I obviously had to figure out what I needed to get for holding the flowers. So for my comfort bowls, I went with my florist and he actually had those for rent, and it was a very reasonable price, especially since I wasn't willing to buy that many and try to resell them. I much rather have rented them and saved my money there. I will say though that one of them ended up breaking the day after the wedding. Try to avoid that, otherwise you do have to pay for that damage, which kind of sucks, but you live and you learn. And then for my gold stands, I got that off Facebook Marketplace, and you guys know that I always suggest going to Facebook Marketplace because you can literally find anything for your wedding. And if not Facebook Marketplace, then you can also find it on Facebook resell groups for weddings. Oh, okay. Other tips that I want to mention is obviously just keep experimenting with different flowers, different looks, and go to Trader Joe's and get those flowers for cheap. I just found it to be the easiest way for me to practice. Especially when I was doing flowers for my bridal shower, I went to Trader Joe's and just picked up a bunch of flowers and practiced that way. And that's the only way that you're really gonna get good at this. And yeah, that's what I have to say. Okay, so now we're going to get into the second part of this video, and that is talking about the companies that I use for my centerpieces. And the first company that I use is PetalDriven.com. They are an online flower resale wholesale shop, and you don't have to have a license to shop there, so that is really great. And you're getting your flowers and greenery at a discounted price. Pro tip, I use a discount code as always, so that also saved me a lot of money. So for my centerpieces that didn't involve any flowers at all, I use them strictly for getting eucalyptus leaves all over the tables. And that honestly saved me a lot of money because I had almost 50 tables, so half of them I did full centerpieces, and then half of them I did terrariums. That is a big money saver, so make sure you kind of alternate between all the centerpieces so you're not spending so much on big centerpieces for every single table. So at Petal Driven, I just bought their eucalyptus, and they come in bunches, so you have to buy them in different bundles. I bought 10 bunches, which I believe is 100 to 113 stems, and they also tell you the length of them. So depending on what you're making, if it's a garland or if it's just going to be on your table, it's really nice to have extra. And for 10 bunches, I paid $132, but I use a 10% discount and I got it for $121.73. So that was awesome because I saved so much money there. And then for the big boy, which are my actual flowers, I used enjoyflowers.com. They are also an online seller that sells bouquets and DIY bouquets, but also wedding flowers for the DIY bride, aka me, aka all of you who are probably watching this. And what I liked the most about Enjoy Flowers was that their prices were really reasonable for what they were offering, and that was in comparison to other companies that I was looking at. And I'll obviously list all the other stores that you can buy from down below, but this is the one that I went with. And the process that I went through with them was amazing. They had great customer service. What I also loved about them was that you can pick out how many pieces that you need for your wedding, whereas some other companies, they actually had pre-arranged numbers, and if you were to break the pre-order, they would charge you an extra cost. They did not do that here at Enjoy Flowers. So the first thing that I did when I was on Enjoy Flowers was to look at all the different styles that they had, and the one that looked closely to my wedding colors and my bouquet colors was their Coral Blossom collection. And I noticed that there was kind of this hot orange flower that was in there, and I talked to Anna and asked if I could get those replaced with a softer pink color, and they did that for a little bit of an extra cost, but it really was not anything major, so I was totally okay with paying for that. So that was super nice that I was able to do that and kind of get a more cohesive look with my flowers. So when you're choosing the different collection of flowers, you also get to choose what kind of flowers that you want. So it could be for the bouquets, the boutonnieres, centerpieces, garlands. And what's nice about that is that they are all pre-arranged, so you know how many pieces go into each one of those bouquets or centerpieces. It's all pre-planned for you. Whereas if you go to Petal Driven, you have to know exactly how many flowers you need for each single centerpiece to get started. And that is why I really recommend going with a DIY flower company, because they really have it all calculated and you don't have to waste any time doing it yourself. So once you pick out your flowers and work with a specialist, they tell you the delivery dates as well as how many pieces that you're going to get in your order. So in my order, I had 25 DIY centerpieces, 2 garlands, and 1 cake flowers. And all of that was for a grand total of $970. But since I had a 20% discount, I only paid $882 for all those flowers. And what's really awesome is that they give you a complete breakdown of how many flowers you're getting, but also also when you get it delivered, they send you so many more than what you actually need. So they really take care of you and send you extras just in case anything goes wrong. In terms of delivery, since my wedding was on a Saturday, the flowers came on Wednesday. I unpackaged everything and I processed everything according to the care instructions. So I had to cut off a lot of the stems, dethorn everything, and put it into water, and I just used big giant ice coolers for that because I already had that. But you can also buy big buckets from Home Depot or something to store all the flowers. And by Friday, the day that I was doing the flowers, they opened up so nicely and they looked really beautiful. What else? I will honestly say that I had no problems in the delivery of the flowers, but it did take me a lot longer than I thought to process the flowers. So make sure that the day they are coming, you are getting those flowers inside the house right away so that they stay cool, and you set aside a couple of hours to just do all the cleaning up, so taking off the bottom leaves, cutting the stems. So Saturday came and I got together with my bridesmaids and made all of the florals together. It took us a good couple hours, even though I had probably 8 or 9 people helping me. It still took us a long time because we were making like 25 centerpieces, and they obviously are newer to making florals, but all in all, everyone still had a good time. I basically created a mock sample, and that way people can kind of see what the look was. I also broke it down into how many stems of each flower and each piece of greenery should be in each centerpiece. I can say it each so many times. It was a lot of fun to work with my bridesmaid, but obviously really stressful because we were cutting it to crunch time. So the earlier you can do it, the better. Yeah. That's all I can say for that. And then for transporting, we put them all into boxes and moved them to the wedding venue, and the wedding venue took it from there. And that was super nice. Yeah, just thinking back at it, it was just such a wild project to take on. So if you are planning to do your wedding flowers, make sure that you are well prepared and well staffed to do it. All right, so that is how I did my wedding flowers. It was a lot to go through, but hopefully you found this information helpful. Another video that I'm thinking to make is actually an overview of all the centerpieces that I made, but maybe that is not necessary, but I'm always open to your suggestions down below. Hopefully you found this video to be super helpful, especially if you're trying to do flowers for yourself. That is all I have for you today. Thank you so much for watching. Watch out for my next video, and I'll see you next time. Bye!